Welcome to the Erecco Service Group YouTube channel. Please remember to subscribe and ring that bell to get notified whenever we upload a new video. In this video, we're going to be looking at heat pumps, and we're going to look at the sequence of operation of a heat pump in both the cooling, heating mode, and defrost mode using this electrical schematic. On the left, we have our low voltage circuits. We have a 240 to 24 volt transformer. In the gray box is our thermostat. We have our terminals coming out of the thermostat, and then it goes to our low voltage relays. On the right side of the schematic, we have our high voltage circuitry. At the top, we have our compressor. Below that is the outdoor fan motor, our reversing valve, our defrost timer, our defrost circuitry, our indoor fan motor, and then our auxiliary heat. So let's go through this with a call for cooling. On a call for cooling, the Y terminal is going to be energized, the O terminal is going to be energized, and the G terminal is going to be energized. So let's heat this circuit up, and we'll look at our Y terminal first. That activates the contactor relay. So the coil for the contactor has now been energized, and let's look up to the right over here, and these contacts are going to close. Okay, so that's going to get our compressor started, and I want to emphasize all of this is happening at the same time, but I'm showing it to you one at a time. Our outdoor fan motor gets energized and it's running. Now our reversing valve relay energizes, and again, this is all happening at the same time. That in turn closes this contact and energizes this circuit. So now our reversing valve has slid from its default position of heating. Now that it's been energized, it has slid over to the cooling mode. So now our indoor fan motor relay is going to be energized. That closes this contactor and energizes our indoor fan motor. Okay, so our compressor is running, our outdoor fan motor is running, the reversing valve has been activated and slid from heating to the cooling position, and our indoor fan motor is blowing. We now have heat going into the house. So let's go back to the beginning here, and we'll have a call for heating. Again, our Y and G terminals will be activated. That in turn is going to activate our contactor relay, which will then close these contacts. This one, and this one. Again, that starts our compressor, and that starts our outdoor fan. Our reversing valve does not activate because its normal position is in the heating mode. Now our indoor fan relay coil energizes, that closes this contact, and that starts the indoor fan motor. So just like in cooling, we've got our compressor going, our outdoor fan motor going, our indoor fan motor going, but our reversing valve is not energized. So that's the difference between heating and cooling. Compressor, outdoor fan, indoor fan. On cooling, the reversing valve would be energized. In heat, it's not. But when we're in heating, sometimes it's going to need to defrost. That happens when frost and ice forms on the outdoor coil like this. When you have ice and frost on a coil, that really cuts down the efficiency of the unit. It can completely ice up if not properly taken care of. So we need some way to melt this frost and ice off of the outdoor coil. So back to our schematic, we're now in heating. Our defrost timer has been running all of this time. I just didn't show it because I didn't want to confuse things. But whether we're in cooling or in heating, the defrost timer is running. They can be set to activate at 30 minutes, 60 minutes, 90 minutes, or what they call auto. Let's say that every 30 minutes, this one closes this contact here. Well, as you notice, we have a pressure switch on the left and a coil temperature switch on the right. If either one of those is open, the defrost relay is not going to activate. that if the coil is below this temperature, that contact closes. Many heat pumps only use a coil temperature sensor, but some also use a pressure switch. As you notice that the frost and ice on that coil inhibits the air from flowing through it, and so there's a pressure differential. And if there's a pressure differential, meaning there's enough frost and ice built up, it also closes that switch. So with both of those switches closed and our defrost timer contact closed, now that circuit activates, which also activates the defrost relay. Okay, so now we've got several things going on at one time. Let's go over to our defrost 2 and 3 over here by the thermostat. We have two contacts there. One energizes our heating contactor. The other energizes our reversing valve relay. The third opens the normally closed switch up here in the outdoor fan motor circuit. That takes the outdoor fan motor out of the circuit. So we still have our compressor running, but now the outdoor fan isn't running. So going back over here by our thermostat, our heating contactor activated and our reversing valve relay activated. So our reversing valve contact closes. That activates our reversing valve. Now remember, its normal position is in heating. Now it's going into cooling mode. What that does is it warms up the outdoor coil. In air conditioning, we're taking heat from inside the house, we're taking it outside, which means the coil outside is going to be warm. In heating, the outside coil is cool, so it'll absorb heat. So we want to warm up that outdoor coil and melt the ice. But we don't want our customers to be cold. So our heating contactor they close. That activates that circuit and our auxiliary heat goes on. Okay, so our compressor's on, our outdoor fan is off, the reversing valve is in the cooling position, our indoor fan is still on, and our auxiliary heat is on. So the defrost timer is run for, say, 5 minutes. That deactivates our defrost relay, which then closes this contact. Remember, it's normally closed. When the defrost fan relay was on, it opened that circuit. Also, our heating contactor opened, as did our reversing valve contactor. Okay, so our outdoor fan motor now has restarted. Our reversing valve contactor opened. Our heat contactors opened. The reversing valve circuit is de-energized. The heat pump goes back into heating and our auxiliary heat turns off. Now we're back in our heating mode again. So let's just review real quickly. In cooling, the compressor is on, the outdoor fan is on, our reversing valve is energized, our indoor fan is on. In heating, the compressor is on, the outdoor fan is on, the reversing valve is not energized, and our indoor fan is on. In defrost, the compressor is on, the outdoor fan is off, our reversing valve is energized, our indoor fan is on, and our auxiliary heat is on. So that's the sequence of operation of a heat pump in cooling, heating, and in defrost.